Today's class is about trypanosoma. Introduction. These are the flagellates that live in the blood or tissue of man or other animals. Coming to the general characters. They exist as trypomastigotes in vertebrate host, that is man and animals. They pass their life cycle in two hosts. They are vertebrate and insect host. Vertebrate host is the definitive host and insect host is the intermediate host. In insect, they pass through the stages of amastigote, promastigote, epimastigote and metacyclic form of trypomastigote. Multiplication occurs in any of the above stages and transmission occurs from one vertebrate to another by blood-sucking insects. Classification. Trypanosomes are classified into three. They are Trypanosoma brucei, Trypanosoma cruzi and Rangeli. Trypanosoma brucei, it causes African trypanosomiasis or sleeping sickness. Trypanosoma cruzi, it causes South American trypanosomiasis or Chagas disease. Trypanosoma rangeli, it is a non-pathogenic trypanosome which causes human infection in South America. Now let's see in detail about Trypanosoma brucei. Introduction. It causes African trypanosomiasis in man. In cattle, this parasite was discovered by David Bruce in the year 1890. Coming to the habitat. It is a parasite of connective tissue where it multiplies readily and it invades regional lymph nodes through lymphatics and also invades bloodstream causing parasitemia and finally localizes in brain affecting the central nervous system. Coming to the morphology. Trypanosoma brucei, it exists in vertebrate host as a trypomastigote form with an elongated spindle-shaped body, possesses central nucleus. At the posterior end, it has a kinetoplast and a long undulating membrane. The flagellum, it starts near the posterior end, curves around the body and continues beyond the anterior end as a free flagellum. Now let's see about the life cycle of Trypanosoma brucei. It passes its life cycle in two hosts. They are the vertebrate host. Vertebrate hosts are man, game animals or other domestic animals. An invertebrate host are tsetse fly of Glossina species, mainly Glossina palpalis. It is the invertebrate host. Both the male and female can transmit the disease to human. In the life cycle, development in man and other vertebrate host. Before that, infective form for human is metacyclic trypomastigote form. Transmission is by bite of tsetse fly and also congenital transmission was also recorded. Development in man and other vertebrate host includes. In the metacyclic stage of trypomastigotes, that is the infective form, are inoculated into a man through skin. When an infected tsetse fly takes a blood meal, the parasite then transforms into slender forms that multiplies asexually for 1 to 2 days before entering the peripheral blood and lymphatic circulation. Then these become stumpy via intermediate forms and then enters the bloodstream. Next, you see about the development in tsetse fly. In the midgut of the fly, short, stumpy trypomastigotes develop into long, slender forms and multiply. After 2 to 3 weeks, they migrate to the salivary glands where they develop into epimastigotes which multiply and fill the cavity of the gland and eventually transform into infective metacyclic trypomastigotes. Here they multiply and change their morphology, which are morphology first into epimastigote and then into metacyclic stage, which are infective to man. This picture shows the life cycle of Trypanosoma brucei in both the tsetse fly and human. Next, about East African sleeping sickness. Trypanosoma brucei rhodesens, it causes East African sleeping sickness. It is a zoonotic disease. Usually, this disease is more acute and patients present with fever, weakness, loss of weight, edema, myocarditis and weakness are more prominent and lymphadenitis is less prominent in this condition. Next, about West African sleeping sickness. Trypanosoma brucei gambiens, it causes West African sleeping sickness. This parasitic infection induces massive stimulation of immune system and complement mediated lysis of host cell that leads to anemia and also patient presents with generalized pain, weakness, cramps, swelling of neck lymph nodes with a winter bottoms sign. Next is about the lab diagnosis. The lab diagnosis of African trypanosomiasis includes the parasitic diagnosis, that is demonstration of trypanosomes in clinical specimen. The specimen collected are Kanger fluid and aspiration of the enlarged lymph nodes, peripheral blood, CSF and bone marrow aspiration. Microscopy is done by wet mount preparation. Wet mount preparation of lymph node aspirates and Kanger fluid are used as a rapid method for the demonstration of trypanosomes. These specimens are also examined for parasite after fixing and staining with GIMSA stain. Examination of GIMSA stain. Examination of GIMSA stained thick peripheral blood smear reveals the presence of the trypomastigotes. Hematocrit centrifugation technique or examination of CSF collected by lumbar puncture also done for the all cases of African trypanosomiasis. Next, about the animal inoculation. Inoculation of specimens from suspected cases to white rat or white mice is highly sensitive procedure for the detection of Trypanosoma brucei rhodesens infection. Coming to the culture, these organisms are difficult to grow, hence culture is not routinely used for primary isolation of the parasite. However, it can be cultivated in veinments or Tobes medium. Coming to the sero diagnosis, various serological methods have been developed to detect these antibodies and are as follows. They are indirect heme agglutination, indirect fluorescence assay, ELISA, a simple card agglutination test for trypanosomiasis, that is CATT, that is called card agglutination trypanosomiasis. Specific antibodies detection in CSF is done by indirect fluorescence assay and ELISA. Other laboratory findings includes elevated ESR, marked anemia, reduced platelet count and low Hb level. For the treatment, in the primary stage, suramin is used. Suramin and pentamidine isoethionate, they do not cross the blood-brain barrier, but it is nephrotoxic. In case of second stage, if patients with central nervous system involvement, malarsoprol is given, which can cross the blood-brain barrier. Next, we'll see about Trypanosoma cruzi. Trypanosoma cruzi is the causative organism of Chagas disease or South American trypanosomiasis. It is a zoonotic disease which occurs in three forms. They are amastigote, epimastigotes and trypomastigote. Amastigotes are intracellular parasites which is 2 to 4 micrometer in size. They are seen inside the reticuloendothelial cells, mononuclear phagocytes and also the striated muscles of heart, skeletal muscle, nervous tissues. It multiplies in man. Morphologically, it resembles the amastigote of Leishmania species. Hence, it is frequently called as Leishmanian form. Next, we see about the trypomastigote. Trypomastigotes are non-multiplying forms which is found in the peripheral blood of man and other mammalian host. In stained blood smear, they are shaped like alphabet C or U shaped. These forms do not multiply in human and are taken up by the insect vectors, that is redweed bug. Next, we'll see about the life cycle of Trypanosoma cruzi. It passes its life cycle in two hosts, that is the definitive host, which is man, and the intermediate host is vector, insect vector. Vertebrate form includes amastigote and a non-multiplying trypanomastigote. Insect form includes epimastigote and multiplying trypanomastigote. The reservoir host is infected redweed bug, dog and rabbit. Human are the source of infection and the transmission is taken place by two cycles. First one is the domestic cycle and the second one is the sylvatic cycle. In domestic cycle, infection is transmitted between man and domestic animals by the bite of blood-sucking redweed bug. It is common in rural areas and also in low socio-economic conditions and poor sanitation condition. Sylvatic cycle includes sylvatic redweed bugs and small mammals including rodents, and these chagas are transmitted by redweed bugs and also through blood transfusion, congenital and also by some laboratory infection. Coming to the life cycle, the development in man occurs. The metacyclic trypomastigotes are introduced in human body by the bite of redweed bugs, which invades the reticuloendothelial system and then spread to other tissues. After passing through promastigote and epimastigote forms, they again become trypomastigotes, which are then released into the bloodstream, and they are the infective stage for redweed bug. In this stage, no multiplication occurs. The multiplication takes place only intracellularly in the amastigote form and to some extent as promastigote or epimastigote form. Then the development in a reduvid bug occurs the infection by feeding on an infected mammalian host. The tripomastigote are transformed into epimastigote in the midgut, from where they migrate to the hindgut and multiply. These in turn develop into non-dividing metacyclic tripomastigotes, which is an infective form, which are excreted in the feces. The development of trypanosoma cruzi in the vector takes around 8 to 10 days, which constitute the extrinsic incubation period. This picture shows the life cycle of Trypanosoma cruzi in humans and the reduvid bug. Coming to the clinical manifestation, it includes two diseases. They are acute Chagas disease and chronic Chagas disease. Acute Chagas disease is more common in infants and children under 2 years of age. The first sign appears within a week after invasion of parasite. Chagoma, it is a typical subcutaneous lesion that occurs at the site of inoculation. Inoculation of the parasite in conjunctiva causes a painless edema of periocular tissues in the eye, which is called as Romanov's sign. This is the classical finding of the acute Chagas disease. Most death occurs in acute Chagas due to heart failure or meningoencephalitis. Coming to the lab diagnosis, for the microscopic examination, peripheral blood by direct microscopy and GIMSA staining is done in wet blood film, and hematocrit centrifugation is done by using acridine orange as a stain. For the culture, Novi, McNeil and Nicol medium is used for the culturing of Trypanosoma cruzi. This is a medium which is inoculated along with blood and incubated at 22 to 24 degrees Celsius. Epimastigotes and tripomastigotes are found in the culture. Culture is more sensitive than the smear microscopy. Coming to the animal inoculation, guinea pig or mice inoculation may be done with blood, CSF or lymph node aspirate or any other tissue material. And here the tripomastigote form is looked for in the blood smear. Coming to the xenodiagnosis, this is the method of choice in suspected Chagas disease if other examination are negative, especially during the early phase of the disease onset. The reduvid bugs are reared in a trypanosome-free laboratory and they are starved for 2 weeks. Then they are fed on patient's blood. If tripomastigotes are ingested, they will multiply and develop into epimastigotes and tripomastigotes, which can be found in the feces of the bug 2 weeks later. Coming to the serology, both the antigen and antibody antibodies against Trypanosoma cruzi may be detected by the following test, that is complement fixation test, indirect fluorescent antibody test, enzyme linked immunosorbent assay and indirect heme agglutination test. Then intradermal test is done. The antigen crucin, which is prepared from Trypanosoma cruzi culture, is used for the intradermal test. A delayed hypersensitivity reaction is seen. Lymph node is used for the biopsy examination, and for the treatment, nifurtimox and benzinidazole is used. There is no effective specific treatment is available for treating the Chagas disease. Thank you.